why doesn't it make any sense at all to buy a reinforced carrier? Here you see three drivers and two used oil pumps for comparison. Let's open the original VW oil pump and we'll soon demonstrate how the carriers work. In principle, there is a play between the carriers, meaning the flanges or surfaces and the bushings. This is an original bit holder, which is visibly worn out, almost round. Here once again seen in detail. When we now push it into the socket, you can wonderfully see that there is play between the surfaces and the bushes. This is a new carrier, original from Volkswagen, touted as a reinforcement even today. And here you can see as well that the game between the boxes and the coupling is large. Here is our coupling, and there we can very well see how we have reduced the game by simply increasing the size. Here again in detail the original and our driver. So you might be getting a hint why one should not just buy a reinforced carrier. That's why we claim so, both with the originals and with the replicas. The only goal this driver should ultimately have is a longer durability. It's pointless to just reinforce the carrier if it still has too small a size and can then knock back and forth in the bushes. Then the driver might be hard and might not wear out as quickly, but the boxes on both sides would end up wearing out just as fast, or maybe even faster, which is much worse. Compared to the bushings, for example, at the balance shaft or the oil pump, the driver is relatively inexpensive. This load analysis clearly shows how the material is deformed by a too small carrier. Ultimately, it comes down to the coupling not only being reinforced, but also having the right hex size. To prevent engine damage, the right driver should always be used. Sadly, frugality doesn't pay off here.